Hi, this is Chuck Davis with Letterhead Fonts. Today I want to show you some neat tricks you can do using the LHF Sinclair Words font. LHF Sinclair Words comes as part of the LHF Sinclair font set. So here is LHF Sinclair, and we're going to change it to LHF Sinclair Words. So you can see the C generates the word cafe. Each letter will generate a different phrase. So the first thing we want to do is rasterize the text so that we can manipulate it. So let's go ahead and right-click and choose Rasterize Type. And now we want to separate the word cafe from the scroll work. So let's duplicate the layer. And then we want to get the polygonal lasso tool and select around the word cafe. What we're going to do is invert the selection and delete the scroll work. So that's going to leave us with only the word cafe on one layer. So select inverse and then hit delete and then go to the next layer and do the exact opposite. And so now you'll see that we have two layers, one with the scroll work and the other with the word cafe. So next we want to color the scroll work, and I like to use hue and saturation when I color, rather than painting in, which would leave a jagged edge. We'll just change the hue and saturation, and then bring the lightness down until we get a dark, kind of muted green color, and then hit OK. All right, so now it's time to do our red background. So let's get the elliptical mask tool and make a new layer, and then we'll drop this layer below our text and just make an oval about in the center. It doesn't have to be perfect, and then we're going to feather it. So we'll go to select, feather, and for the resolution I'm working at, 30 pixels would be good. Hit OK, and then we're going to fill it in with the red color I have. And so there you can see it creates sort of a spotlight effect behind the letters. But it's a little too bright. It's taking away from the letters, so let's bring the opacity down so it's not so bright. Show some of the black through. Okay, so now let's create an outline around our letters. We'll do this by creating a mask of our letters. Hold Control and click on the layer. Command if you're on the Mac. Go to Select, Modify, Expand, and 3 pixels will be good for what we're doing. Hit OK. Now let's make a new layer because we don't want to put the outline on the same layer with our text naturally. And then go to Edit, Fill, and we'll fill this in with black in this case. And then hit OK. Alright, so deselect the mask and you'll see we've got a nice bold outline that separates the letters from the background. Let's go ahead and make it even better with a shadow. We'll duplicate our outline that we just made and then nudge that down 3 pixels and over 3 pixels. I like to put my shadows on the bottom right. Alright, so that looks pretty good. Now it's time to do the ornamentation and effects inside the letters. So let's make a mask out of our letters again and go to Select, Modify, Contract, and 2 pixels is good for the size I'm working at. And on a new layer, we'll make a new layer. We're going to fill this in with our foreground color, which happens to be red right now. It doesn't really matter what color it is because we can always change it in hue and saturation later. So we'll put that above our letters, of course, and you can see the effect that it creates. Now, that's too stark, so let's go ahead and change the color. We're going to go into hue and saturation here and play with the sliders until we get kind of a, I think a burnt orange would look good. So, there we go. And now we're going to erase the top portions, maybe about the top quarter of the letters. So I get the eraser tool and a soft brush and set the opacity about 25, 26, and of course choose the airbrush tool. And we'll just go across smoothly. Smooth strokes are important because if you miss one area, it'll stand out. You want a real smooth fade effect. All right, so you can see that's a nice effect by itself. But let's go ahead and add in this lines file that I made beforehand. I have this horizontal lines file, which is just what it is, a bunch of horizontal lines. But we want them to go vertically. So we're going to rotate this. So rotate it 90 degrees clockwise. And then we're going to create a mask, yet another mask out of our letters again. And then select, modify, contract. And again, 2 pixels. And then we'll go to select, inverse, and hit delete. And that will delete all the lines outside of the letters. And it's white. That's what color I made it in the first place, but this will look better in black. So let's go back to hue and saturation and move the lightness slider down to the left. Okay, so we're almost done. We've got one last important step here, and that's to erase the top portion of the lines now. Otherwise, the effect won't look quite natural. So here we're just going down slowly, smoothly across to erase the top portions of the lines. Okay, so we're almost done now, but one last thing. I don't like the darkness of the orange color now. With the black lines on top, it made it just a little bit too dark. So because we've done everything on separate layers, it's easy enough to just go ahead and select this orange layer and go back into hue and saturation. And we'll bump the saturation up a little bit and move the lightness to the right. And that'll make for a much brighter orange. That looks good. You can see that's really popping now. All right, and there you go. That's an easy effect, and it really only took a few minutes to make.